prophethood, then there's going to be the righteously guided khalifas, which is Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, and Ali. And then there's going to be mulkan adan, kingdom with justice, you know, kingdom with something justice. Then mulkan jabriyan, then kingdom of hardship. And then it's going to come back khilafa ala minhaj al-nubuwa. So they said those five stages happened from the time of the Prophet to the time of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. The time of Umar Abdul Aziz, here, see, the Prophet didn't tell us directly, so it could be right. First the Prophet, then the four khalifas, then we had kingdom with justice in it, Muawiyah radiallahu an, and some other khalifas, and then mulk and jabriyan, kingdom with oppression, and then it came back to khilafah again under the hands, and that's what he wanted. In fact, some of the scholars congratulated him, told him, you're that one who brought back the khilafah and the path of the minhaj of the nubu. Some scholars say, no, this hadith applies that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his time is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's time is the time of justice, the prophethood, then the four khalifas, then after is mulk and jabriya, the kingdom of Bani Umayyah and some of the Abbasi, justice, it had some justice in it. Then it was Jabriyan, when every Khalifa would give his son the power, and it's continued until today. They believe just because a certain phase of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz's life was righteous, it doesn't mean that whole phase turned right. So it continues on till today, and you probably see that today. You see like Ali Abdullah Saleh wants his son to be a leader. Right or wrong? That, is he a king or a president? He's a king. He's a president. He's a president by name, but in reality a king. And Hosni Mubarak wants his son to be a president. He's a president. How could a president have a son be a king, a president? He's a king. King Fahd. Qaddafi, the king of Morocco. Almost everyone. So this is the mulk and jabriyan with oppression and deviance from Islam. And they say the next phase to come is the Khilafah and the Minhaj of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Inshallah.
How old was Umar bin Abdul Aziz when he took Khilafah, and how old was he when he died?
I don't remember the right age, but it's 50 something. And all he did, all he led was 2 years, five months and 7 days.
Is it true that before he was a Khilafah, he used to live
the... No, Khilafah.
I mean, that's wrong.
Nah.
Before he was a Khilafah, he used to live
Yes.
He was righteous, even though he was...
I don't know much about it. I know that he governed in many towns, and amongst them is Medina Munawwara, and he was very just in them. How he got his wealth, I don't know. But I know when he took Khilafah, he gave all his wealth and all his wife's wealth. But maybe it was halal, but he just didn't want it in his house.
Sheikh, will there be many Khalifas before Mahdi comes, or will there be just only one?
Allahu A'lam. Allahu A'lam.
Sheikh, a question about, you know, the Khalifa issue. You know, in so many stories, when the right man comes and chosen to be a Khalifa, he denies it. Would it be a sin to deny such stuff, like not to take responsibility while you know that you are the appropriate guy to be in this situation? Like Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he almost denied that first. Then Umar also denied it. Then Ali denied Khilafah, then they forced him. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz also, he didn't want the Khilafah and they forced him. So is it like not the same, but shouldn't be done like this, you know, he should accept it.
Well, there's the thing behind that is they denied it because they were humble. That's a good thing to do, but it's not a bad thing to ask for something if you feel no one's more fit for it than you. Mm-hmm. If you believe being a general in this army is gonna be, you have something others don't have, and you believe that, there's no problem asking for it. But why these people denied it? Because this is a huge responsibility, a huge responsibility. And these people were fearful of Allah, you know. Although they wanted to serve Islam, they probably wanted to serve Islam as soldiers rather than as leaders. But, you know, it's not haram or it's not bad to ask if you're not asking for the power. You're asking because you know you're so sure that no one better than you could serve that position. It's not haram to do it. In fact, there's examples, I can't remember them, where it's Abu Talha, I can't remember what he asked to be in a position and who was granted that position. So if you know you're fit and you no one else and you're not asking for the position but rather to service them, then yes. But usually you find like these people who refuse the Khilafah are the leaders who revive the Ummah.